Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to take a look at .bit, which is a Web3 decentralized domain name that you can use for a variety of different things. Obviously, nothing I say on this channel is financial advice. Always go away and do your own research before investing any of your own money. Without further ado, let's jump into today's video. So guys, this is did.id, which is linked down below in the description. So a .bit effectively is a domain name, a decentralized domain name that allows you to use it for whatever it is that you want. It's not just a domain name, it's a storage method that you can go and use to store different things. You can create trust wallets to enable you to have a simplified ID name that someone can then go and transfer you crypto rather than using one of those long wallet addresses like you get for Bitcoin, Ethereum. It's a cross-chain Web3 blockchain, so it enables you to change across Bitcoin, Avalanche, BNB, allows you to use Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Avalanche, etc., and transfer data across all of these different ones. So cross-chain Web3 identities for you and your community. It's kind of like link trees. So you know your favorite influencers, etc., often on their Instagram, they'll have a link tree which enables them to send people to their website, to their Twitter account, YouTube, etc. So think of it like that. You can then get your Bit ID just by clicking in here to see if it's available. So I'm just gonna put in my name like this, and then I can search for it to see if it's available. And right now it is available. I can register it as an Ethereum NFT or just as a normal .bit. If I register it as an Ethereum one, it's gonna cost me $5.76, but you do have a chance by coming across here to get this for absolutely free. I'm going to look at that later on. At the moment, there's 224,000 registered accounts and they're filling up fast. So if you want to secure the very best one for you, then make sure you head across and check it out as soon as possible, guys, because they are being bought up quickly. You can take back your sovereignty with a .bit. So traditionally in Web2, yes, you have things like Facebook, your Instagram account, but they are all owned by that particular platform that you're using. You don't have much say in what you can put on there. It's always going to be controlled by someone else. However, Web3 is completely different, where you contain all of the data you want without anyone else having any say in that. I mean, down below you can see a lot of different examples. And what you can notice as well is you can use things like emojis, a .bit, to completely personalize the way that you use it. Each .bit is a powerful self-sovereign data container, which is very, very cool. And you can see that the key here is the information and then that the value is put into a long chain like this. So you can use things like trust wallets, various different tokens, etc. Then you can run all of them through a .bit address. Coming across to a name DAO, which is initiated by the .bit community, and coming to where it says guidance, then it's going to talk you through how you can become a DAO member for absolutely free, and then you can register here for your .bit account, which you could potentially then receive for free by doing this. It talks you through all of the different process and how you can do it, and all of the benefits of becoming a DAO member, such as various voting rights and all sorts of other bits and pieces. There's a treasury with 50% of the sales from the revenue of .bit accounts going to the different DAO members. And then there's also benefits like governance, voting proposals, constructing a name DAO, tools, and like tons of other different features as well. Name DAO will be linked down below, guys, if you want to go and check this out along with the .bit pages. So here's an example of what you can create with a .bit account. This is bestcase.bit. You can see that they have their different profiles here for their Twitter, GitHub, Discord, etc. They also then have their different addresses. So when you want someone to send you something like Ethereum, Bitcoin, you just send them the address like this. They can then go across, find the address and send that particular token to it. And then they can also create customs here. They've got like their NFT collections, various other bits and pieces. Then there's more information on the different permissions. So if you're running a business, etc., you might want to outsource the permissions to other admin managers, etc. But this is a really cool, like, decentralized link tree where you are the ultimate controller of everything that gets put in here. So think of it like kind of like a digital business card that has all of the information for all of your different platforms, as well as your wallets and everything like that, enabling you to operate completely with your own sovereignty outside of any other system. Safest way to look after your crypto is have it in decentralized wallets. Obviously, over the years, we've seen many crypto projects and crypto exchanges pull the rug, basically taking everyone's money from within that platform and then not giving it back and disappearing off the face of the earth. Coming across their Twitter then, guys, you can see 106,000 users. They've already raised a significant amount of money in funding. So this could really take off as a project, and buying into .bit names, potentially names that you might think might be in demand in the future, then you could potentially be able to make some money selling those names on. Obviously, that's not financial advice, guys. Think about how you could potentially see returns doing that. For example, like Web3.bit, that's a really cool way to maybe make some money. You could then auction them off on eBay. Just an idea. On the website itself, there's tons of other information about how you can use your self-sovereign data container for like more secured places to store your addresses. Also stuff like your profile information. Here you've got an example for this person here with all of their like different information down below. And remember, it can be used on like an app, etc. So a very cool way to store all of your useful information. There's other resources like dweb resources, and then you can store any type of data. It's not limited to the stuff I've talked about. So if you wanted to create like your own Google Drive or whatever it is, guys, you can do all of these different things through this platform, and then you can use it for whatever it is that you have requirement for. And basically, you know, Web3 is absolutely taking off. The Web2 that we know, with like the Twitters and the Googles and the Facebooks, will continue to sort of survive for a while, but they are starting to integrate into a Web3 environment. And by setting yourself up well for Web3 environment going forward, it puts you in a great position once the whole world moves into Web3 and you are already set up and good to go. So in summary, guys, .bit is a fantastic platform like Linktree that enables you to create an individual sovereign platform to share all sorts of information, whatever information it is that you want to share. Whether you're an influencer and you want to share your YouTube, your Instagram, various other different pieces, you can store your wallet so that people can transfer you money easily. Just by showing them a .bit website, they can then go and access all of those wallet addresses and send you money if you want to do things like that. Think of it like a digital business card with everything that you really have operating out there. Really fantastic information available on the website, so all of it's linked down below. Come and check it out, guys. If you enjoyed today's video, make sure you smash that thumbs up button. Thanks very much for doing that. Helps out more than you know. And if you're new to the channel, you want to learn more about Web3, NFTs, crypto, and so much more, then make sure you subscribe to be kept up to date with all of the latest happening. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you soon in the next one. Bye-bye.